Hey and welcome back to the channel. My name is Alexander and I'm a guitarist, composer and overall music nerd from Copenhagen, Denmark. And today we are taking a look at a spacey clean tone for the Line 6 Helix. Enjoy! Alright, so in this video we are building an ambient clean tone using the Playcator amp. And as you maybe know, I've done a video using the Playcator amp before that you can find up here somewhere. And I had a little more time to spend with this amp. It was still fairly new to me when I did the previous video, so I think I did a bit of a better job with this preset, and I of course hope you feel the same way. As you'll hear in the demo in just a minute, it is of course an ambient clean tone or a sort of spacey clean tone, but I think it functions really well both for rhythm playing and for leads. So if you are in the market for a sparkly and bright clean tone that you can use for both of these things and add a bit of ambience to your track, rock or metal or whatever you might be playing, maybe this preset could be something for you. So before we dive into the tone demo and the walkthrough in Helix Edit, I have to say, please consider subscribing to the channel, like the video, say hi to me down in the comments, or maybe share the video with a friend who would also benefit from this tone. And as always, I would like to direct your attention down in the description. There's a lot of links down there that would help support me and support the channel. For example, you can head over to my website and you can pick up all of the Helix presets that I did in the past, all of them that I'm going to do in the future, and this exact one for only $10, and you only pay once. And of course, I understand if you don't have any money to spare with the world being what it is and these crazy times, but fear not, a subscription, a like, or a comment is just as good, and I appreciate it just as much. All right, so now we have all of that out of the way. Let's head into the tone demo and then dive into the walkthrough. See you there. If you're interested in composition, lessons, music production and tutorials, make sure to subscribe to the channel and ring the bell so you don't miss my weekly videos. All relevant links are in the description, it's all free, so you have no excuse. Do it for glory! So welcome back to Helix Edit, guys. Let's take a walk through this clean, spacey ambient tone. And once again, I am on my Ibanez AC with the Simon Duncan Hyperion pickups, just so you know the sort of reference point if you have a similar guitar or you kind of know what these pickups sound like, right? Okay, so let's just dive right into it. As I said in the beginning, we are, of course, working with the Playcator amp once again, and I haven't worked with it before 3.0 or 3.01 came out, so I thought I would revisit it and see what I could do, and I actually ended up using nothing from 3.0, and I'm a little slow and a little old, and I don't like change, and this worked out pretty well for me, but I think I did a better job than I did the first time around. So let's just dive in. As you can see, the Playcator on the clean channel, and the drive is at 4.6, the bass is at 4.7, treble at 6.8, presence at 4, master and channel volume boosted all the way up as I normally do, because of the way my physical unit is set, and I like the volume to be around there. The bright switch is on 1, the sac and ripple are both at default at 5, and I changed the bias and the bias X, so the bias is at 6.1 and the bias X is at 7.2 this time around. And I felt that this gave a little more sort of low end. When I took them all the way off, it got really like too bright or too hissy or harsh in a way, and I I regularly don't play around with these too much, but here it really made a difference when I scooped them up just a little bit, right? And of course, the cap is the 2x12 Match G25, and it's mic'd with a 57 dynamic, distance 1.5 inches, low cut at 80, and a high cut a little more aggressive than I usually do at 8K, right? And then we get this. The first thing I usually do when I found the sort of bass ground tone, we could say, as I did now, played around with the amp, the volume levels and stuff like that, and of course I boosted the volume over here by plus 12, and that is fairly normal for me as well in the multi output. And again, it's because of the physical settings on my board at the moment. Okay, and then I have input gate is off this time because we don't really have any drive. We have a little drive pedal, but we'll get to that. But I figured I actually didn't need it, so I didn't put it on this time. And that is a first for me, and probably a lot of metal guys as well. But of course, if you have really high output pickups, these are sort of medium output, I would say. If you have really, really hot pickups, you probably need a noise gate in there as well. And there is room for it if you're using the new 3.0 tone switching thing, where you give up the last bit of DSP space down here. You can totally do that as a free space. Okay, so the first thing I did, as I usually do, I throw in a compressor, and here it is first in the chain this time, and it's the Rochester compressor. And now it sounds like this. Right, and it of course gives a little bit of sound, right? If we take it off again. It makes it easier to play, as that's the main reason why people use compressors, I guess. And of course it squeezes the whole thing together, makes it a bit more focused, and the low volume things becomes a little boosted, and the high volume things are brought down a little bit, as a compressor does, right? But it also adds a little bit of gain, and I don't know if you can hear it, a little bit of sizzle, or a little bit of grit, right? And normally for a clean tone, if it should be like jazz or totally clean, we would not want that, and we would pick a different compressor. But for this being drenched in delay and reverb later, I think it's okay to have that little bit of drive, because it makes the volume of the actual notes cut through the whole sort of blanket of space and ambience a bit more. And that's a personal preference for me. And I think I actually just used the stock settings. So gain at plus 3 dB, threshold at minus 24, ratio at 10 to 1, attack at 10 milliseconds, release at 100 milliseconds, and rest is definitely stock. Knee all the way off, level at plus 10, mix at 100%, right? If you want to get rid of that grit, you could use the Deluxe Comp or the LA Studio Comp. I would suggest those, they both sound really good. Okay, so now we landed here, right? And then we added a little drive pedal. And you can hear, sort of reintroduces the clean signal. So actually the grit that the compressor put in, it dialed down a little bit. We can still hear it all the way under, but the sort of actual sound of the guitar and the actual sound of the note is brought up and pushed a little bit further, right? And this is actually a fairly new distortion pedal for me, at least. I think I used it once before, not on this channel, but on a personal preset of mine. Normally I would use the Screamer 808, but for this with the Playcatter amp, no matter what I do, it makes it a gritty tone because it pushes it so hard, right? So I stumbled across the Minotaur, and I found these settings: gain at 0.3, tone all the way up, and level at 5.5. And for me, it's the perfect balance between that little bit of grit to cut through later when we put on the effects, and also getting the signal of the guitar a bit more through, right? Okay, so that is that. And then, as you'll notice, this is a little new to me, putting delays in front of the amp as well, but I know it's a pretty well-known trick out there. So let's start with the two that are after the amp, right? And here we first have a delay, the transistor tape, and the settings are, just for this particular demo that I did, they are 446 milliseconds, feedback at 60, wow and flutter at 3.6. The scale is at 100%, spread at 2.9, mix at 34%. It makes all the difference with those 1%ers. Level I didn't touch, and headroom I didn't touch, and trails are off, right? So we get this now. Right, pretty long feedback. That is what we want when we do these really ambient and sort of atmospheric tones, right? And of course the mix is, it's fairly low, right? It's not totally, it's still in the background of the clean notes, and that is what I was talking about with the drive pedal and the compressor really help pushing the signal of the guitar through this carpet, right? And that's an important thing to me, at least. Then the verb is the glitz, and the settings are 3.8 for the decay. The pre-delay is at 18 milliseconds, low cut off, and the high cut is at 16k. The mix is at 17%, so also fairly low, right? Level is default at 0, delay at 64 milliseconds, rate at 0.9 hertz, depth at 3.8, X over whatever it is at 900 hertz, and the mod mix is at 3.6, and trails are also off, right? Right, so we take it off again. Oh, sorry. So you can hear now it actually sounds really dry. Makes it sparkle a lot, right? And really adds to this whole ambient thing. And that's of course what we want. And then the final step is of course the pre-amp delay, we could say, right? And here we're using the, I'm not gonna try to pronounce that, I'm just gonna butcher it, delay. And the settings are similar to the one in the back, but it is of course a different pedal, right? It's transistor tape, and here we have the delay, and and the settings are 446 as well. You could do something if you set it to the global timer. You could have, for example, a quarter note delay after, and an eighth note delay before, or the other way around, or dotted eighth note and quarter note, or something like that is also very popular. So you can play around with that if you need it for a specific song or something like that. So this is a really, really broad strokes. And I didn't want to get too specific with the timing and stuff like that. So that's the same, and the feedback is a little higher at 55%, noise at 3.6, and the BBD size is at 4096. I actually not sure at all. I think that is bit depth or something like that. The mix is at 40%, so also a bit higher, and the rest is just stuck, right? And trails again still are off because I don't use snapshots or anything fancy like that. And there's a lesson in that as the mix before, right? When it's before the amp, it's good to have it a little bit, sorry about that, a little bit wetter or a little sort of higher dialed in the mix. At least to me, for these kind of tones, it just sounds better. And of course, both the reverb and the delay are affected different ways when they are in front or behind the amp, right? Like putting something in an effects loop or sidechain, stuff like that, will make it sort of impact the tone a different way. So play around with that, but I usually tend to have my effects in front of the amp dialed a little bit more aggressive, if we can say that, about delays, for tones like this, right? Okay, so it sounds like this. Space, so if we take that off again, we get this. Right, still sounds good, but I really love the sound of that kind of lo-fi-ish kind of delays. And of course, as I said before, if you differ the times, you'll get that sort of more stereo ping pong effect, and you can really affect them differently with, in this case, the noise, or how clear of a repeat it's supposed to be. You can play around with that, but for this, it is stacked, right? So what we hear is the exact same time of two delays with two different sounds. So they are kind of matched to sound this way together, right? And in my opinion, these two pedals sound really good together. I haven't had the time, or at least the need, to play around with too many of the delay pedals. But if there are some of them that you really like that you think I missed, feel free to hit me up in the comments with those. But I tend to gravitate towards the delay we do not speak of and the transistor tape. I tend to like those quite a lot. All right, so this is the entire tone, and I hope that you, of course, enjoyed it, and you can use it if you want to build it on your own, or you want to simply purchase it from my website. I will, of course, very much appreciate that. All right, I think there is an outro coming, or I know there is an outro coming, and I think you should watch it. See you there. Unfortunately, we have reached the end of the video, guys. Thank you very much for taking the time out of your day to watch the video. It truly means a lot to me, and I of course hope that you liked the tone. As always, consider to subscribe to the channel and like the video, say hi to me down in the comments, or maybe share the video with a friend who would also benefit from this clean tone. So all that's left to say is I hope that you are well out there, and you are of course staying inside and playing around with your Helix, and I will see you maybe next week. Until next time, see ya.